Hello, everybody.
It is July 27th, 2024. We're over here in Daytona Beach preaching the gospel. If you need prayer today, well, that's what we're here for. We're He already told me what I needed to read. I'm going to read what he told me to read. But boy, he loves you. I used to tell the Lord, can we just pour your love in him, Lord? You know, I was like, just pour your love in him. And he's like, then they won't love me. They have to want me. I wouldn't force them to love me. Then they won't love me. I said, boy, I always say love you because you're amazing. So anyway, I wanted to, you know, save everybody. That's what the Lord wants. He doesn't want anyone to perish. He doesn't want anybody to perish. Doesn't matter what you've done. That doesn't matter. Who did Jesus use? What did Saul do before he became Paul? He murdered Christians. Do you think Jesus knew that? When he chose him? Yeah, of course he knew that. He knew everything about him. And he chose him. When Jesus came for Saul, the Lord blinded him so he could see. He blinded him. And he said, oh, the words that you're speaking, Lord, they're piercing my heart. They're breaking my heart, Lord, when you speak. That's what Saul said. He goes, oh my gosh, what have I been doing? I've been murdering all the people that have believed in you. And here you're trying to make me right after I murdered all the Christians? You love me? He's like, my God, I can't keep my eyes off of you. I love you so much. That's right. That's what the Lord said. Yeah, preach it. Yeah. He said, Saul, you just don't know who you are today. But I'm going to show you who you are. So I'm going to make you blind. And then when you open up your eyes today, you're going to see who I am. And when Saul opened his eyes up, boy, Jesus took him away so that Jesus could fill him up and teach him who he was. He needed to tell him, I love you. He needed to heal his wounds. He needed to restore his soul. He needed comfort. He had to take him away for 3 years so he could fill him up with his truths. And Jesus restored Saul. And then before he sent him out to go preach the gospel, he changed his name to Paul, who wrote most of the epistles in the Bible. And
they asked why he came back.
Paul went out to preach the gospel. And everybody was scared of Paul because he murdered Christians. But here he is preaching the word. He went to the same places. Paul was beaten for preaching the gospel. shipwreck. He was cast down, and he kept standing up. He said, I got to preach that name, Jesus. Whether I live or die, I'm the Lord's. I'm crucified with Christ. It's no longer I live, but it's Christ who lives in me. And this life that I live is for him alone. And Paul was in prison. And when he was in prison, do you know what he wrote? In prison, the day before he got his head cut off, what did he say? Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. How could he do that? Because when you get Jesus, you're never going to die, honey. You're never going to die. You see, we already died for Jesus. You can't kill us. Those who are in life in Christ Jesus had to die. That is, if you're 100% holy and spending your life with the Lord 24/7, day and night and night and day. That's the only ones he accepts. You know, the pure in heart will see God. Y'all need prayer?
Oh, y'all come on.
No. Have a good day. I need prayer. I'm going to pray, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, to the King of Kings. What's up, Anita? What's up, Anita? Anybody hungry? The Lord will feed you. He's feeding you the word today. He's going to heal and transform you today. Because he loves you. Father, we thank you for all the people here. We thank you for what you're doing. Your presence is here. Your love is here. Your peace is here. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for your great love that you have towards us, Lord.
Thank you.
Pray that the Lord gives you strength today. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to give you strength, he says. Inner strength. Give him inner strength, Lord. We need inner strength. Some of you are getting real weary. Some of y'all getting tired and well-doing. You need a fresh wind. You need a fresh wind. A blow over you, the breath of God. I breathe life inside of your body. I love you, darling. I grow the breath of God inside of your bones, inside of your body. Be restored. Be made whole. You're loved and adored. You're accepted in the beloved. You're accepted. He accepted you. And when before you even were placed in your mother's womb. Don't forget it. Don't forget it. He wants to heal you and transform you. Come over here. I'll pray for you. When two come in agreement, it's going to be done. We have angels here. We have the armies of the living God. We have the angel of the Lord here. We have seraphims here. We have cherubims here. We got all of heaven rejoicing over you today. We have all of heaven coming in agreement today. You're going to be healed and restored. Daytona Beach will be delivered, restored, and made whole today. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will prosper, Daytona Beach. We won't have addiction on our streets. We will no longer be a slave to the enemy. We drive you out in the name of Jesus Christ. Every unclean and godly spirit, we drive you out and you can never come back. Get out of here in Jesus' name. This land is going to be a land of love, power, and of a sound mind. This land is restored. It's built up. We planted the tree of life here. The tree of life, that's in heaven. We're planting it right here. Yeah, planted it right here. And the roots are going down deep. And this tree is very much fruit. Can a city be delivered in less than a millisecond? Yes. Can this land be better than it was before? Can this land come up again and come alive in the blood of Jesus Christ? My God. With God, all things are possible. And he will perform his work. Short is righteousness, and it is finished. It is done. It is a done deal. Daytona Beach is forever changed. Daytona Beach is healed. Daytona Beach is a land of lovers of one another. Daytona Beach has compassion and love for one another. Daytona Beach is encouraging one another. Daytona Beach has so much food and water that nobody will ever hunger and thirst again. Daytona Beach We'll have places that people can rest, gather, souls restored. Oh, my God. Daytona Beach is going to be a house of praise. My gosh. Did you hear that? Do you know who you are? This is who you are. You live in Christ Jesus. You come out and you set a city free. You set the land free. You set the earth free. In the name of Jesus Christ, He gave you all power, all authority, all dominion in heaven and in earth. My God. I don't know how I'm in one piece today. I don't know how I'm staying together today. See? When you know who you are, you're gonna change something. You're gonna change everything. I made you to be the head and not the tail, above only and not beneath. I made you to come out from among them and be you separate. I made you to not be wicked. I made you to not touch unclean things anymore. I made you to be holy as I am holy. I put goodness inside of you. I put love inside of you. That's why you aren't a good hater. That's why you don't even know how to hate good. You know why? Because I put everything inside of you. I put my spirit inside of you. I put my love inside of you. I made you complete before you even came here. That's why it doesn't work when you're away from the Lord. That's why you can't get anything right. Because nothing's right unless you're with the right God. And that's Jesus Christ. Every knee's gonna bow to Him. Every tongue is gonna confess that He's King of Kings and Lord of Lords. There's no other name that saves, honey. He's sitting on the throne. He's laughing at His enemies. He makes His enemies His footstool. My God. When you know who you are, you'll do this too. You'll rise up. You'll rise up. You won't be dead anymore. You won't be hiding somewhere. My gosh. We need to, everybody needs healing here. Is anybody going? I've been preaching for almost 13 years. I don't see people preaching on the streets. Where are they? Says in the Word, go into all the world, preach the gospel of all creation, then I'm going to come. Why aren't you moving? That's a good question. Do you think you were deceived? Do you think you went the wrong direction? Do you think you believed a lie and became the lie? Stop drinking the Kool-Aid, it's not for you. Stop drinking sorrows. Drink of me, Jesus says. I am the river of life. I'm life eternal. I'm love eternal. I'm life everlasting. My gosh, baby. Dance with me, Jesus. My God. Tell him you want, tell him to dance with you. You'll be undone for 13 years. Tell him you want him to heal you and touch you right now. My God. You'll never be the same again. You'll laugh at your God. You'll be like, my God. You never healed me. You never gave me anything but stealing, killing, and destroying. And here comes Jesus. Oh, I give you life more abundantly. I heal you. I restore your soul. I make you whole again. I created you a new heart. I do all things, but I can never fail you. I can never leave you nor forsake you. I'm the only God who's sitting on his throne, ruling and reigning now. Everything is made subjected under my name, Jesus says. Your name is lower than Jesus. He's above your name. He's above all your gods. He's above every name in this world and even in the world to come. Preach it. Preach it from the rooftops, baby. I'm trying, Lord. Where's the rooftop? I'll go. I'll go wherever you tell me to go. I'll do whatever you tell me to say. I'm not going to waver. I'm going to tell you the truth that sets you free. That's what you need. You don't need no cotton candy serving. You don't need no sugar donut and flavored coffee. Going to dead churches every day and being dead, secular, carnal, lukewarm. I'm going to vomit you out. You lukewarm ones, you choose not to serve love. Lukewarm. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Not. Not. We be dancing at the club tonight. We be fornicating. You don't know Jesus. You don't know Jesus. You slayers of drugs, you ministers of the gospel, you thieves, you robbers, you adulterers, you fornicators, men slayers, abominations of men. And you're going to a church like that. And you're not healed. You know why? Jesus said, follow me and you'll live. Jesus said, serve Jesus Christ himself and you'll live. And you've been serving men all day. And you're going to die where you're at. Unless you get Jesus. You can either live or die today. Which one is it? Which one? Live or die? For me or against me? Which one? Which one? By your words, you're justified. And by your own words, you're condemned. You're judged by your words. You're judged by the fruit of your mouth. What you speak today, you're going to become tomorrow. How's that going for you? What are you speaking today? You need to get Jesus. And then you'll know what to say. But without Jesus, you can do nothing. Jesus, you'll never see the Father in heaven. You'll never get to heaven. You'll never be delivered. You'll never be healed. You'll never be transformed. You'll never know who you are. You'll never be loved. And you'll just live a broken life. My God, who wants to do that? Not me. I'm going to be loved 24/7. I'm going to be cared about 24/7. I'm going to receive the love of the Father every second of my life. You know why? Because I love Him. You choose today. Choose today who you serve. The Lord says, He says there'll be many in my day. He said there'll be many that try to come to Him. Didn't we cast out devils in your name, Jesus? Didn't we do mighty good works? Weren't we thieves and robbers? Didn't we rob and rape your children? Because He knows what you did before you even went. And you know what Jesus is going to say? Depart from me, I never knew you. You would do iniquity. When I was hungry, you didn't feed me. When I was thirsty, you didn't give me a drink. When I needed love, you didn't give me love. You just used my name to merchandise the gospel. You just used my name to get women. You're just seducers of women and men. You don't even know me. If you knew Jesus, you'd be holy. You'd be changed. You'd be a holy vessel. That's all he accepts. 100% for me, or you're against me. Which one? Do you think you can play with fire and not get burned? The enemy came to kill, steal, and to destroy you. How's that working for you? And here's Jesus. I can set you completely free today. I can make you a new creation. Creating you a new heart. So many benefits to this love. I'll take it all. I'll take more. I'm addicted to Jesus. Give me more. I'm addicted to the Holy Spirit. Fill me up more, Holy Spirit. I'm addicted to the Father in heaven. Give me more. Give me more. Your children are hungry here, Lord. Hello. Your children need it. They're hungry for love. But unless we come out from them and be you separate and serve the Lord Jesus Christ, you're not going to know him. You must love one another as I've loved you. You must love one another as I've loved you, the Lord said. I give Jesus while it's time. What happens when it's going to be shaken? See, if you're 100% for Jesus, you're against him. See, he marks those that are 100% for him and stay with him. They follow the Lamb everywhere he goes. He knows those that are his. But if you aren't his, and it's going to start shaking,
guys,
what kind of kingdom are you going to be standing on? Your kingdom's sinking sand.
Yep.
The enemy was defeated 2,000 years ago, and you serve him day and night. And Jesus is sitting on the throne, laughing, in a good mood, while you're getting rejected by a loser. What kind of God is that? I wouldn't serve a God like that. I'm going to serve a God that loves me, that takes care of me, that protects me. All right, we're going to read. We're finishing reading Matthew chapter 5. Nathan. relationship with Jesus, you're going to have the best time of your life.
Hey, baby.
You always have fun. Hey, darling. Have a good one. Aren't you glad I didn't come over there? I know. I'm so glad the Lord didn't tell me to go over there again. I was like, you're getting me in trouble. Have a good one. I'm not getting in trouble. Matthew chapter 5. We're finishing the Beatitudes. Thank you. Thank you, Father, for your word. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your caring and compassion that you have towards us. Thank you, Lord, that you're restoring hearts and minds today. And restoring bodies today, that you're making them whole today. That's what you came to do, Lord. You came to heal your sons and daughters today. That's what I'll do for you. I'm going to be reading the word. If you want prayer, make your way over here. We have free anointed prayer cloths. Everything's free over here. The Lord came to give it to you today. Everything you need. He loves you.
Give to him that asks of you, and from him that will
love your neighbor and hate your enemies. But Jesus says, but I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you. Children of your Father, which is in heaven, for he makes his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and he sends rain on the just and on the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Don't the sinners and the publicans do that as well? And if you salute your brethren only, what do you more than others? Do not even the sinners and the publicans do so too? Be you therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect. Thank you for your word, Lord. If anybody needs prayer, free prayer calls. If anybody's hungry, we have snacks here. Have a good day.